We're here at CBS 2016 in Nairobi, in Kenya, and I've got the great pleasure of being today in the studio with Mr. Suleiman Zuhairi, who is Deputy Minister for Telecommunication and Information Technology for Palestine. Deputy Minister, thank you very much indeed for being with us
today. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to be here.
Now, I know that this is basically an important subject for you, or you wouldn't be here, as I'm sure your time is precious. I wanted to find out from you, what have been your impressions of this symposium?
First of all, I'm coming, yes, from very far away, from Palestine. I have to go to Cairo, from Jordan to Cairo, from Cairo to Nairobi, so it's really very far distant. But I think it's worth it. The symposium is one of the most important symposium I ever attend, because it is tackling one of the most important issue, which is ICT related capacity building. And for ICT capacity building, this is as a moving thing, because ICT is moving very, very fast, and we have to cope with this acceleration of services, with technologies, so such as, for example, IoT, Internet of Things, and OTT applications, mobile application, cloud computing, big data, you name it, cyber security. So many things we can talk about, and it is a very good opportunity for a developing country to learn more about this subject.
What are the major challenges for you? Is it connectivity? Is it availability of content?
Maybe both, but in Palestine we have different challenge, which is the migration of the skilled people to the Arabic Gulf country. And this is a really a challenging issue, because they are looking for better environment, better job opportunity, maybe better salaries, wages, and all this stuff. So this is one of the most important challenge. So you have to find a way to get out of this problem. It is in all countries which have limited resources and with low income. So these kind of obstacles will push many people to go outside the country looking for a better job environment or working environment, financially and socially even.
There have been a number of conversations going on here, very stimulating conversations. I wanted to find out from you, have there been any key takeaways for you?
Yes, I learned a lot from my colleagues, from ministers, deputy ministers, other people coming from all over the world here. So it's a good platform to learn more about many subjects, especially the up-to-date titles or subjects, like I said, OTT and IoT and all this stuff.
What do you think is the key to improving global capacity building through ICTs?
Sharing the knowledge, transferring the knowledge, and convincing the developed country to invest more in developing countries, because without this kind of investment, especially in places like Palestine, where the income is very low and resources are very limited and under occupation, we can't survive unless other big brother can put their hands in our hands.
Do you think that young innovators have got a good part to play in this?
Yes, one of the main important subjects the CBS address is the innovation issues, also building like center of excellence, building vocational training center to address new subject in ICT. But when you talk about incubators and startups, I think this is a good opportunity for our countries to develop their economy in this regard, because entrepreneurships incubator, which is the platform for the startups, is a good solution and can suit our position and our status in Palestine and on all other countries which is have similar conditions.
And what about the role of governments in this?
Yes. I think the government should recognize first the importance of capacity building and should create and have strong, up-to-date and effective legislative and regulatory framework in order to facilitate things to academic sector and private sector in order to initiate utilize centers, excellence centers, and innovations, and all these kind of things, which is can at least bridge the gap, digital gap between developing country and developed country.
So, are you optimistic for the future of capacity building?
As long as the ITU is highlighting this kind of issues, I think yes, I'm optimistic because we learn a lot and we can implement what we already learned from this symposium in our countries. I think at least it will give us another opportunity to have better life, better economy, and better development.
Suleiman Zuhairi, Deputy Minister of Telecommunication and Information Technology, Palestine. Thank you very much indeed.
You're welcome.